Hello, family. So good that you could join us. So if you like the message that you're about to hear, don't forget to share it with your friends, your family, just everybody. The message is going to be so amazing. Also, we would like to thank you for your generosity. It is because of your generosity that we are able to spread the gospel Sunday after Sunday. So yes, enjoy the service.
Hello, hello. So today we are wrapping up our series called Celebrate. And I hope by this time you realize that God has actually created us to be people who celebrate God's goodness. And if you read through the Bible, you will find so many scriptures that are just are full of references pointing towards heaven, and that heaven is a joyful place. Heaven is actually in full on celebration mode. And I'm hoping that through this series, you realize that you can be in celebration mode. You know, on earth, there are many things that just want to come and steal our joy. Maybe it's a difficult situation that you're facing, and maybe it's some disappointments that you've experienced, or maybe it's a misunderstanding of what Christianity is all about, and you're stuck in something that is empty religion, and you have a misunderstanding of what holiness is. So I'm hoping that through this word today and through this series, that you will get an understanding of why we can celebrate and how we celebrate as believers. And we find our joy in God. He is just so amazing. So I'm just want to start us off by looking at Philippians 4 verse 4. So it says in the New Living Translation, always be full of joy in the Lord. I say it again, rejoice. So Paul is actually writing this letter from jail. So, and not a very comfortable jail, a difficult situation. And in the midst of this situation, he's telling people to have joy in God, to rejoice, to celebrate God's goodness, because he has experienced the power of coming in alignment with heaven and celebrating God. And you know what? You and me, we can also experience that power when we celebrate God in the right way. So we're going to finish off our series by zooming in on what does it look like to celebrate with others. All right, so for that, I want to take us to our main scripture for today, and that's in Romans chapter 15. I'm going to read verse 5 and 6 in the New Living Translation, and it says, may God, who gives this patience and encouragement, help you live in complete harmony with each other, as is fitting for followers of Christ Jesus. Then all of you can join together with one voice, giving praise and glory to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. So one thing we need to see from the scripture is that God has not just called us to celebrate and have joy as individuals, but it's also something that he has called us to with other believers. And when we say that we celebrate with other believers, we need to know that this is more than just being alongside another believer, worshiping in a, let's say, in a corporate worship experience, but it's actually celebrating what God is doing in other people's lives, in the person next to you. The thing is, oftentimes our celebration is actually quite self-centered. It's all about what God has done for me. It's all about what He is for me, but not really what He is for others and what He has done for others. Yet, as Christians, we find our lives in Christ. We live for Christ. He is our he is the one in that our lives revolve around. But Jesus came and He died for all of us to be saved. Okay? So whoever believes in Jesus will be saved. And that means that we, if we are in Christ, our focus is going to be on other people, and we are actually going to love our neighbor. And it means that we are going to celebrate God's goodness in the lives of people around us. Now, sometimes the celebration can be simple. It's maybe celebrating somebody's birthday or wedding. And then when I'm saying celebrating, it doesn't mean then just pitching up and getting some food and then running away again, but really being happy and joyful for that person. Or it can be that you celebrate somebody just having done well in a test that they've written, or maybe they got a bursary or they got into some graduation program that they were interested in. So they can also mean that maybe you are celebrating somebody else's graduation program or bursary that you were actually interested in. And this actually shows something about our spiritual maturity, about whether we can celebrate and be happy for somebody else when they have received a breakthrough that you're still trusting God for. It shows spiritual maturity and it shows faith. And because if God can do it for somebody, He can also do it for you. So it's actually supposed to build our faith when we see somebody else getting the breakthrough that we want. Now, one thing we also need to know is that when we celebrate what God is doing in somebody else's life, there's a bonding that takes place. We bond and we get excited, and that person is excited that you're excited with them. And so we all grow together, and actually loving our neighbor comes out again. Okay, so I want us to now look at Matthew 20, verse 28. Okay, it says, "Even as the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give His life as a ransom for many." So here we see something about Jesus that has come. Jesus has come and He's modeled a certain attitude that His believer, or the people who follow Him, we that are believers, actually need to have the same kind of mindset in. We have to have the same kind of heart and actions that we show, and that is a life of service. So we say that heaven is celebrating, and it's important for us to come in alignment with heaven, just like Paul did. It's actually, we are resonating with heaven. So it means we're making the same sound. We're vibrating in the same frequency. And the way that Jesus did it and the way He showed us is service. Now, that's not normally the first thing you would think, but we can celebrate God's goodness by serving. Serving is a key for us to experience joy in our relationships with other people. It's actually one of the best ways you can do it. And we serve not out of duty, but because we are resonating with heaven. So that is the thing that's motivating us. And in this process, we are bringing heaven to earth because we are resonating heaven. Now, there are many ways that you can serve a person. And there are many ways that you can bless somebody and find joy out of it. But I want to point to three major things that will bring, I would suppose, is the best ways that you can serve somebody, the best way for you to experience joy. And the first one is leading people to Jesus. I want to point out two verses that we find in the parable of the lost sheep in Luke chapter 15. It says, "So he told them this parable. What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he has lost one of them, does not leave the 99 in the open country and go after the one that is lost until he finds it? And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and neighbors, saying to them, 'Rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep that was lost.'" Now the other verse, "Just so I tell you, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who need no repentance." So you see from the scripture, we serve others by sharing the good news, and we can invite others into a life with Jesus, into His life-giving life where they can actually experience life. Remember, without Jesus, we are all lost in our sin. But Jesus comes and He gives us life, and we can invite people into this heavenly celebration. So if you're wondering, oh, how do I tell other people about Jesus? Guess what? We got you covered. We have all the resources that you could ever need. Just talk to us. If you want, you can send a message to the page from which you're streaming this video, or you can contact any of our ministry team people, and we can hook you up with everything that you need. And also, if you haven't been at a place where you have actually made a decision to follow Jesus, I want to encourage you to join the party right now. There's no better time than now to give your life over to Jesus, to submit and actually find true everlasting joy. And for that also, please contact us. We want to guide you through the process. We want to walk with you. We don't want to just leave you. We know how amazing and an important step this is. And we want to give you the opportunity to take hold of it fully. And speaking about that, actually, another way that we can serve somebody else is by discipling someone. In Matthew 28 verse 19, we read, "Go therefore and make disciples of all nations." Now, this is Jesus speaking. He continues to say, "Baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you." So we see making disciples is way more of us just taking somebody where they go through salvation and they accept Jesus. It's a process of walking with them, helping them to follow Jesus and live the kind of life that He has called us to live. And in this process, you will have so many opportunities to celebrate, seeing how they grow, seeing how they get breakthrough. You know what? I'm so proud of the people that I disciple. When I look at their lives, when I see where they are now versus where they've been, how God has been faithful in their lives, it really just energizes me and it makes me excited for me even to grow more in my walk with God. So again, every nation has tools available for that. It will help you to disciple other people, and we would want to disciple you so that you can grow with God. So contact us for that. I'm saying it a lot, but really we are here to walk with you and to equip you in discipling others. Then the third and last way that we can serve people that I want to focus on today is that we can pray with people for a miracle. So it can be different kind of miracles that people might need in their lives. Maybe it's a healing breakthrough in their bodies or for a family member, or maybe it's provision that you see somebody needs. Let's look at Acts 7:8, verse 7 and 8, and it says, "For unclean spirits crying out with a loud voice came out of many who had them, and many who were paralyzed or lame were healed. So there was much joy in that city." And this scripture is referring to Philip that went and he preached the Gospels and he did miracles. And one thing I want you to notice is that we can become bringers of joy to our cities. You can impact a city through miracles. Now, a short while ago, I think in last week or so, Marquay got a message from Pastor Roger. Now, Pastor Roger is the leader of our movement in the Southern Africa region. And a while ago, he had something wrong with his leg, and the doctors actually told him that you won't be able to run and jog again. And he just loves doing that. And Marquay just stepped out in faith. She went to him, she took me along, and then we prayed for Pastor Roger's leg. And guess what? It got well. And now he's celebrating you on his Facebook, and he's just sharing with everybody he can run again because God came in and he did a miracle. And we are celebrating with him. And you can partner with God to bring joy into other people's lives. It's actually so easy. Again, there's lots of equipping available on that, but we get to connect with God through miracles and also with other people when we minister. And what's amazing is when you see God move like that through your own life, you know that He can move in your life at the same way. So if you're trusting God for a miracle, maybe step out and trust to see that miracle in other people's lives, knowing that it will build your faith for your own miracle, for your own breakthrough that you need. So I actually want to close up for us. I don't know what your picture of heaven was before, but I'm hoping through this series that you will understand that heaven is full of joy. If you're still unsure, go and read Revelation chapter 5 and get this picture where there's this continuous praise because God is so good. People, they see, angels, they see God's goodness, and we can actually see it right now as well. And they know that God will make everything work for those who love Him. Everything works out for us. And so we can have joy, we can celebrate. And we best reflect God when we realize that He is happy. We best reflect Him when we know that He's not angry at us anymore. That we can live in that place of celebration because Jesus bore the punishment for our sins. We don't have to be worried. Heaven is not worried because God's plan will work out. He is an almighty God and he is all wise and he makes everything work out. Satan has already been defeated. How amazing is that? God wants you to experience joy and he wants to partner with you to bring joy in the lives of people around you so that you can celebrate with others. So I just want to take a moment and pray with you. Father, I just come and I thank you that we can find true joy in you. You are a good God. Thank you, Jesus, for paying the price for our sins so that we can live in a place of eternal joy and eternal celebration. And God, we don't want to be selfish and celebrate on our own. So help us to apply these words in our lives so that we will be able to see this joy almost being infectious and touching other people. I pray your blessing over every person watching this video. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. That was an amazing word. Thank you so much, Pastor Jurgens. So if you loved the message, do not forget to share it with your friends and your family. Also, please follow, like, and subscribe on all of our social media platforms. Finally, if you would like for us to pray with you for something, please dial or call the number on the screen. We would really, really love to pray with you. There are people on the other end of the phone call ready and willing to pray with you. Also, if you'd like to join the Connect group, please do the same. Yes, thank you so much.